Okay, number whatever video. That's the actual building that houses the antenna array, or as people like to nickname it, the ray gun. It's 26 feet long. And what drives it? Well, let's talk about that in a minute. Get around here. Chair. Many RF generators here. Different modulations, different field strength, different frequencies. Okay. Different weird things here that are all tuned in, and they go out on coax cables to the ray gun. A computer is used here to generate tone analogies into these amplifiers and that. Main amplifiers up there. Crown amp, and that goes through a bunch of cables that go up to the ray gun, or interferometer, or antenna array, basically. So how does it work? Well, it's not high tension, but within milliwatts mostly. It will cover this watch if you walk around with a radio receiver, plus it covers other areas around off this lot too. And then it fades out and goes into space and all that stuff, so. Anti-nuclear issues, as well as in the Gulf of Mexico, documented by scientists, by the way, did before and after tests. You can look at all the reports on my SlideShare. SlideShare.JohnKHutchison.net. Piles of stuff uploaded there from the Gulf of Mexico and other situations, as well as radioactivity monitoring. Now, this is all done by scientists and Nancy. I just was the technician, basically, getting ideas myself, but yeah, so all these are tunable, different frequencies, and with external modulation and all of the generators, you send out not video, but audio signals you can pick up on a radio receiver. They may sound a bit weird, but also the trees transmit it. You put a radio next to a tree, you pick up all kinds of interesting sounds from all this stuff. Something I haven't really covered, have I? I think I did once. No, it was covered in the Gulf of Mexico by TV people. And scientists. It was a lot in the media. Then move to different locations in here. This is focused on radiation. As you may know, Navy VLF transmissions actually affect cosmic rays. I know in scientific fact, buck it up. And I'm really into VLF transmission and reception, and ELF reception and transmission. It's kind of like mixing something together. It's interesting. But it does work. As I said before, it was like Steve Colburn did a lot of before and after stuff with oil and radioactive material, and wrote up reports on it. They're on SlideShare too. Steve Colburn. Come on, get with the program. It's been running for years. And was running in transit too, to the Oregon coast, then down here. Okay, we'll cover that for fun. I don't think we covered it much, but mostly covered by other folks. Let's see. One of the most. Oh, what was that called? Media programs. Main media programs. Okay. Check it out on SlideShare. Ask me questions if you want. We'll get into VLF again. That rack there is full of VLF stuff. Let me get around the corner there. I don't know. Let's see. Because I gotta drag a cord because my iPad's battery is pretty screwed up. It only lasts for a few seconds. Keep it. I don't know how much time it works. Stand up for this. Stuff there, and there's other pieces over there. This is Orlikon Canon, by the way. building a Canon carriage down the floor, the working area over there, and more stuff hither and yonder. Came on. Just do a quick look around. Radar systems and like an iPad. Okay, I'm gonna unplug.